Hey everybody, I'm Blackjack. Welcome back to Mafia 2. Welcome to Chapter 5, The Buzzsaw. In the last chapter, we took on Chapter 4, Murphy's Law, in which we stole jewelry from a jewelry store.
Hi there.
Joe ain't here right now. He said for you to meet him for lunch at Freddy's.
I see.
Too bad you were passed out when I came in. We could have partied. Maybe next time, doll. Bye.
Huh. That was something.
In which we stole some jewelry from a jewelry store, ran into, what was his name? O'Neill. And outran the cops, and that was about it. So now, I guess we're gonna have to go meet up with Joe at Freddy's. So why don't we head outside for a little bit? Might have a slight cold now.
Fuck you, stupid broad! But get the hell back here! If you can't drive, you should stay home where you belong!
Hey, isn't that Joe's girl over there?
I never understood why he got mad. He's the one who crashed into her.
You smacked up my car, I'm gonna smack up yours! Look at my fucking car!
Hey, pal, knock it off.
And who the fuck are you?
Somebody who doesn't like hearing you talk to a lady like that. So why don't you shut the fuck up and leave while I'm still in a good mood, huh?
What, is she your girlfriend or something? Well, if she's not gonna pay for it, you will.
One more word, and you're gonna need a new set of teeth. Now get the fuck out of here. That was the word.
That was the word. So now we're gonna kick the shit out of Dub. I guess he's kicking my ass now, I guess, huh? of this dude. And justice will be soived. Because ain't nobody gonna mess with a m'lady. I should have been wearing the fedora, damn it. Fucking damn it, that would have been hilarious.
Thanks, handsome. I owe you one. Do you want to come over to my place for a piece of pie?
Yeah, thanks, but look, I really gotta get going.
You'll like it, I promise. I gotta get going now. I'll see you around.
Fucking funny would have been if I just went total fucking nice guy on that dude. Fucking fedora. Thorolarian and shit. Roll up with my body pillow. Oh man, that would have been hilarious. Alright, so now we're going to Freddy's bar in a taxi. Don't know why I picked the taxi. I think it was just the first car that was there. Swerve. I don't know what the fuck I'm doing. I don't remember why. I guess I just wanted to take this guy's car. I don't know, man. Don't ask me why I drove away. I forgot. I recorded this, like, weeks ago, man. Then I got mad busy. Alright, I guess I just wanted a non-taxi for this mission. Such a fucking dumbass, man. Fedora wearing.
Hey, fellas.
Hey. Hey, Vito, this is Luca Garino. He'd like to talk to you and Joe. Luca, this is Vito.
Good to meet you, Mr. Garino. How you doing? I don't need to be so formal. Call me Luca. Take a seat, Vito.
What can I get you?
Same thing I'm having. And hurry it up. I heard about you running with the mix. Great fucking story. And I want to congratulate you, too, on a job well done. Salute.
A salute.
You guys did a hell of a job. Not too many guys got the stomach for this line of work. So now, I'm wondering if yous are ready to take the next step.
Yeah, sure. What next step?
I'm talking about taking somebody out. Just because someone points his finger at him and tells you to do it.
I was in the war, Mr. Guarino. All I did was kill people I was told to kill. People the president pointed his finger at.
That's good. The president. Yeah, I like that. But you're talking about the Krauts, right? You know, the bad guys. That's not what I mean. Understand?
Yeah, I understand.
Good. We need guys like you. Guys who can follow orders without asking questions. You handle this next job like you handled the last one, and there's a good chance you'll be accepted into the family. After you pay the initiation fee, of course.
And how much is that?
$5,000 apiece.
That's a fucking fortune.
Hey, nobody said it was cheap, huh? But trust me, the benefits far outweigh the cost. I'll leave it up to you two to decide. Henry's gonna fill you in on the rest. I'll see his guys
there
later.
You are.
Hey, your boss.
You take care of that thing we talked about yet?
Yeah, yeah, it's all under control.
That's Henry's what you said the last time. Don't disappoint me again.
Boss,
Now come with me. We got some other business to discuss.
So, Henry, what kind of job are we talking about here?
I gotta take a guy out. It's my contract, but
thanks.
I need some help. That's where you two come in.
Who's the lucky guy?
Some fat fuck from across the river. The guy's been warned, but he thinks he's untouchable.
Huh. And is he?
Well, somebody tried to take him out once before.
And?
Let's just say they slightly underestimated him.
How much is slightly?
Fatally.
That's a fancy way of saying they're dead, right?
Hey, they fucked up. We won't. I rented an apartment across the street from his business. We'll sit there, and we'll wait till that fat fuck shows up, and then boom! We blast his ass.
How are we gonna do that?
With an MG-42.
Where are we getting an MG-42 from?
Harry.
Yeah.
He's a vet, like you. He's got a private little gun shop over in Kingston. You can get your anything from a pea shooter to a bazooka. And you don't need no fucking gun license, neither.
Okay, Joe and me will go to the apartment. You go pick up the machine gun at Harry's shop in Kingston. It's all paid for. Just tell him I sent you. After that, meet us at the apartment. It's in Sand Island, the building across from the distillery. Apartment 233.
Okay, apartment 233. Got it. I'll meet you fellas there in a bit.
How about it? See you later.
Good luck, pal.
Luca Guarino's lip looks really fucking weird up close. I don't know. Am I the only one who thinks that? I was just staring at it the entire time. It's bugging me out. Alright, well, I guess now we're going to head out to, what was his name? Harry's? Henry's or Harry's? To pick up a light machine gun, like kind of like the one from the first chapter, the one where you have to shoot at the tank, but like that big one. We're gonna use a very similar, if not the same, weapon of mass destruction, and it's gonna be great. I actually really love this chapter, mostly because this part is really fun. Oh, I didn't. What? I missed that. Not a that trophy. Oh well, whatever. Probably had something to do with like me drifting or something, or maybe I jumped or something. I wasn't paying attention. I didn't see it pop up. So this is Harry's. I think from this point on, you can go to Harry and pick up quite a few different weapons. I never did so.
Who's there?
Henry Tomasino sent me to pick up the stuff he ordered.
Okay. Come in.
Mostly because I just straight up forgot. But, yeah, this is a good place to buy guns.
Hello?
So, you're the guy Henry was telling me about, huh?
Yeah. You got his merchandise.
Yeah, well, here it is. MG-42, made in Germany. Hitler's buzzsaw, we call them. She's a beauty. 25 pounds. 7.92 caliber. 1,200 rounds per minute. Fastest in the world. 250 round belt. 3/4 mile effective range and extremely reliable. I don't know what the hell you're hunting, but unless it's in a fucking tank, sayonara, baby. Hey, you need me to show you how to use it?
No, thanks. I'm familiar with him. I was in the service, too.
No shit! Wait, are you kidding me? Where were you? What was it, Normandy, huh? No, Africa? All right, let me guess.
Operation Husky.
Yeah? What unit were you in?
504th Parachute.
No shit, you were a paratrooper? That was kind of hairy, I heard.
Yeah, well, it wasn't no picnic, I tell you. I got hit, so they sent me home.
Yeah, any medals?
Yeah, Purple Heart and a DSC.
Whoa, wait, you got a cross? Let me tell you, they don't give those babies out for nothing. I was in Normandy. We hit Utah Beach. Yeah, that wasn't no picnic neither, but when I was crawling over the fence on the way back, I poked my eye out on a fucking tree branch. Well, hey, it was good enough for a discharge.
Look, guy, I really gotta get going.
All right. Hey, by the way, I'm Harry.
Hey, Vito.
Hey, good to meet you, Vito. Real good. If you ever need some hardware, you know where to find me. There you go. I hope you drove here. She's a big girl. Good luck.
Hey, thanks. Nice to meet you, Harry.
The gun's in the crate, and there's a couple thousand rounds in the van out in the yard. Take it. It's all paid for.
You mean to tell me you had an entire conversation about how you lost your eye, by the way? That is the most fucking fantastic way to lose an eye. And you guys never once mentioned your name to each other? You know each other's dick sizes, yet you don't know each other's names. Harry's an interesting character, but I don't think we ever see him again in this playthrough. I think that's about it. I'm trying to remember if I ever did go back. I don't believe I did. But yeah, so now we can just take what's it called? Harry's Schubert something truck. That guy wanted to die. He ran at me and wanted to die. I don't know what his deal was, but I needed to get the fuck out of there before the cops were called. So, you know, I drove away real quick. Yeah, now we're on the way to the location to which we are going to be using the MG42, was it? We gotta make sure we take out this guy, and this gun is gonna be, hopefully, the murder weapon. Like you said, if it's anything but a tank, we should be getting something along those lines. I'm paraphrasing, all right? I don't remember. I was staring at his dreamy mustache and that wonderful eye patch of his. Reminds me so much of that beer. Anyway, to the mission, Misery Lane. Wow, I had never noticed that. Oops.
Where you from, Henry?
Sicily.
What brought you to the States?
Mussolini.
Let me buy you a ticket.
Don't be a smartass, Joe. My father was a man of honor. Things got pretty bad for us after Mussolini came into power. My old man figured I'd either get drafted or locked up. So he sent me to America and got me a job working for Clementi.
So what happened to your father?
He said he was too old to make the trip. Mussolini had him arrested, and he died in jail. They won't even turn his body over for a proper burial.
That's rough.
So how's your English so good?
They're coming. Those black cars.
Aim for the fat bastard. We gotta nail him before he gets in the building. Get ready.
All right, I'm on.
All right, showtime.
They got guns up there in that window.
All right.
That's him, Vito. Waste that map.
Mission's map. I died here like 10 times, so I'm not gonna lie to you. I died quite a few times.
We got them all! Stop shooting that fucking thing! I'm going dead over here!
Oh, I was gonna say something. I totally forgot what I was gonna say. Oh, yeah. I was really suspicious of Henry. Like, I don't know. Just something about him. I don't know. Maybe it's nothing. Joe has the best one-liners. Oh, there it is. Oh, he's gonna say it like 20 times though, so don't worry about it. Even if I'm talking over, you'll hear it. You shoot like my sister. See, that's the one line I don't get. I can't tell if he's talking about me or if he's talking about the enemy when he says you shoot like my sister. I can never tell. If he means me, then that means his sister is a hell of a shot, because damn do I get them headshots. If he's talking about the enemy, then damn, is her sister, is his sister an even better shot, because they pull off some bullshit shit. Bullshit shit. I don't think I ever saw that one before. They pull off some bullshit stuff, I'll tell you that much. Damn. Oh, and he slid. Oh, that was gross. That was ugly. Holy shit. Gonzo. Alright. I love the shootout levels in this game. They're really hard, but they're really fun. Like, I don't know what it is about them that I find so hard yet really fun.
Go, we'll cover you.
Like the last level was mad difficult. It's also like one of my favorite levels though. No, seriously though, I don't know what he means when I...
What the fuck is that?
I don't know, is that Harpoon? Oh god, I just ate something. No, I have Harpoon. Great. Nothing like being 20 and having Harpoon. I don't know what the fuck I ate. Jesus. Anyway. Maybe it's all the gunfire. My body's just like, I can't handle it. That guy killed me because I wasn't paying attention. I turned the corner and fucking he shot me. I had like half health. That was fun. That was the thing. So yeah, when Joe says like you shoot like my sister, I still have no idea if he means me, if he means them. I have no idea.
Way to get you.
I like the shotgun in this game, but like it's really inaccurate. Like they'll be in my crosshairs, and I swear it'll just fucking miss. But every once in a while, like, I'll just shoot blindly in, like, semi their direction, and I'll kill them instantly. Like, it's the weirdest thing ever.
Stay sharp, Vito. Oh, it is. Shot me. Alright, Vito, go.
Although the best gun in the game is probably one of the top guns. Any of the automatic guns is like, the best gun.
Okay,
in the game.
Hit the button, Vito.
I didn't know what that was. Alright, so we're gonna hit the button. Funny enough, I also died at this elevator, too.
What the hell are you doing, Joe? What? Thirsty. Pretty good stuff. We should try it.
Drinking on the job, huh? Wouldn't you turn Irish?
Wouldn't you turn Irish? So yeah, if you can ever find an automatic weapon, like a Tommy gun, or MP5, what the fuck is it? Whatever the other automatic gun is. or other guns are. There's a few of them. Like, I would use them. They're really good guns, especially if they're using them, like if the enemy's using them, because then you'll have a ton of ammo.
Come on,
that'll
upstairs.
Pretty much never run out. Rather useful. I'm not gonna lie to you, I'm surprised I survived. So this game does have a healing factor into it, but it doesn't have one where you go into full health. You'll always have, I want to say like two-thirds health, but that's enough for you to die in one hit. So if you're ever low on health, just take it easy, take it slow, hide behind cover. For the most part...
Don't kill me! Please! I got a wife!
You should have thought about your wife before.
Just don't kill me! Oh, for Christ's sake!
Don Clemente sends his regards. Oh! Fuck!
Fuck you! Sorry, you
fuck!
Henry, you okay? Where'd he hit you?
Of course I'm not fucking okay. He shot me in the fucking leg!
Oh yeah, it's bleeding all over.
Son of a... Get me to El Greco.
The fucking painter?
No, the fucking doctor,
okay,
you idiot.
Take it easy. I'm gonna get you there in a minute.
The Greek guy lives up in Highbrook.
Right, let's get you to the car.
Maradona, you're heavier than you look.
Like I was saying, if you're under heavy fire, just stick to the covers.
I fuck.
You should,
shut the walls off.
Take it easy, Mr.
You should be fine. Just, you know, take it slow. For the most part, if you have, I want to say, like, teammates, like Joe or Henry, on your side, you should be okay. That doesn't really mean you're going to make it out alive. Right? It just means that you won't have as bad of a time as, say, like, you're on your own.
Need to get pissy.
So now we gotta protect Joe and Henry, mostly Henry, from the enemy.
Are you scared yet, boy?
So I don't know who these guys are. I want to say they're mafia. Oh fuck! I died here. Holy shit! I don't remember that. Oh. Oh, good thing I got the checkpoint. Anyway, I don't really know who these guys are. I think they're just random.
Let me shut my balls off.
I guess.
Take it easy. You missed him by a mile.
I'm gonna shut my balls off.
Come on, V.
Alright, cool. Anyway. So, you're pretty much clear up until that room where I died.
Hey, careful. This fucking hurts.
Yeah, well, you can walk if you don't quit your moaning.
Excuse me.
Hey, you're fine. I don't need to get
yawning
pussy
again. What was I saying?
Bleeding to death here.
So you should be fine up until that
please
point where the door opens.
I don't
opens
want to die.
I'm not sure if there's a second door that opens. I don't know.
Let's go.
I mean, anything's possible, right? But since
so
they're coming out through one area
on
anyway, using the shotgun is probably... Yeah, see, that's what I meant. Like, I wasn't aiming at him. I still killed him. But aiming the shotgun is probably your best bet, just because it's a small opening. It's widespread. But you see what I mean by the aiming is weird? Like, half the time, like, I'll be aiming at them, and I'll miss, and then the other half of the time, I'll be aiming somewhere in their direction, and then it is drop dead. I think there are two really good pistols. One you only get in one mission, and then the other are sometimes you'll find magnums. And the magnums are really good. You don't want to run across the fire, by the way, you'll burn and get hurt. So you gotta go the way where there is no fire.
Alright. Oh,
fuck.
Right, and now
if
we get
I
to the.
Make it.
Hey, don't go saying that, pal. It's just a scratch. The doc will give you a few stitches, and then we'll all go out and celebrate.
No, really.
Shh. You shouldn't talk right now. Helps conserve your strength. I've seen that in a movie.
Yeah. And what happened to the guy in the movie?
He died.
So now we're on to the hard part, where we got to make it to El Greco's before the timer runs up. I lost to this a few times. Some of them were pretty funny, though. Like, one of them, I got arrested, like, right outside the door. And the other one, I had, like, plenty of time to make it. But they shot at my car engine, or, like, I crashed or some shit. And my car engine went down, and I went to steal another car. And the guy pulled me out of the car and started beating my ass. And I was like, fuck it, I give up. I don't have enough time to kick this guy's ass, take his car, and make it to the end.
Just get me to El Greco, dammit. Hey, Vito, step on it. Henry's sweating like a whore in church back here.
I died a few times.
Drive faster, you start a Z.
I feel like, though, that this mission gets easier the more times you fail, though, because, like, the first time I lost to this mission...
Throw him a couple of bucks, he patches you up. No questions asked.
He's the guy you go see when you can't go to the hospital.
The first time I passed this mission, I had, like, no time. But, like, every other time, I don't think I changed anything. And I had plenty of time to spare, so I have no idea how it works.
You shouldn't need to visit him, though, Vito. You've always been a quick healer. Must be your diet. Keep that shit up, and Henry's a dead man. Come on, Vito. At this rate, we get there faster if we walk. Hey, Henry, you awake? Stay with me now.
Yeah.
Just hang in there, pal. We'll be at El Greco's in a minute. I can smell the souvlaki from here.
The souvlaki from here. I'm trying to remember if I fast forward to this or not. I don't remember. Alright. The house is literally up this hill. It's like the first one to the right. I end up failing just as I get there. I don't know how I managed to do that.
Hey, step on it, or Henry's done for. If he dies, you're burying him.
Oh, wait, no. The first house on the right, that's someone else's, right? Shit. Is it? Oh, you know what? I was thinking of someone else, of a different mission. My bad. Sorry, there's a mission later on.
That house, park right in front.
Yeah, I was right. This is El Greco. No, I was thinking of a different mission later on where you have to make it to someone's house under a time limit. And I died like four times. Never mind.
You El Greco the doctor?
No. I'm the fucking painter.
A friend needs help. He's gonna bleed to death.
Thanks, Doc.
Good God, Henry.
We owe you one.
Get him inside. Hello, though.
Wait. I got money for you. For the job. Take it.
You know, this could have waited. But thanks.
And hey, thanks for everything.
Hope you'll be okay.
Yeah. Me too.
I'll stay here with Henry. Meet me in my place.
All right.
What if Henry died? Would I not have gotten my money? Anyway, now we have enough for our what's it called? Our debt. We should probably stop by and hand it off to Frankie. She'll put it to good use. Paying off that guy. Whatever his name is. So, oh shit. I just remembered the car was wanted and I saw that one, so I wanted to steal this car. So we're gonna just fast forward our way all the way over to Francesca's house.
Ah,
or rather,
damn it.
Vito's mom's house. Sorry, my microphone wire was touching my foot, and I didn't know what it was because it, like, grazed my foot. Felt weird. Anyway, enough of my random ramblings. Oh, yeah, I wanted to show off the apparel system. So, if you're ever wanted, you can just go into any clothing store. I'm not wanted at the moment, but you can go whenever you are wanted and no cop is trying to get to you. Sir. You can talk to this person and pick an outfit. I think I just picked like one of the first black suits I saw. I was like, I don't want a raincoat. I'll take that one. Or this one or some shit. I forgot. I picked one of them. But it'll be in your closet until
anything else I can do for you?
Something happens. For instance, the next chapter, something happens. So after that chapter, you won't have your clothing back. So let's say in chapter 2, you bought all the clothing. You won't have clothing after chapter 6. Well, the same thing with like a different chapter. I think it was like 11 or 12. I forget exactly which one it is, but it's one of them. So don't worry about the clothes. It's not like a collectible. It's just something that you wear to like get rid of the wanted level. I'm so dumb. I don't know why I'm doing that. Oh, and here I was just thinking, I was like, damn it, I could have just driven all the way over here and went to that apparel. But whatever. It don't matter. As long as you make it to Frankie's house and hand off the money, you're fine. Oh, and say you don't have enough money, you're going to need to work at Brewski's to get money.
No. I just wanted to give you the money to pay off Papa's debt.
Oh, Vito, that's great. I was gonna try and see if we could pay it back in installments. I got a little money. He wouldn't have hurt us.
Don't be so sure, but it doesn't matter now. Here,
where'd you get all this money, Vito? You haven't done nothing you'll be sorry for, have you?
Don't worry. Everything's fine.
Thank you, Vito. Thank you.
No problem. Alright, look, I better be going. I don't want Ma to see me. She'll be asking where I got the money, too.
Don't worry. I'll make something up.
Alright. Give her a big kiss for me, okay?
Take care of yourself, Vito.
I'm so happy I want the nice guy routine and wear my fedora. Oh, I'm such a fucking moron. Actually, you know, now that I think about it, I'm probably misremembering. I'm thinking of chapter like 14, I think, where if you don't have enough money, you gotta work at Brewski's. I don't know about this one. I don't know how this one works, because they give you $2,000 anyway, so I don't know if you spend it all at like a clothing shop or whatever, it will if it will like need to be done back again by working at Brewski's. Not that it's hard to go to Brewski's and drop off like 5 cars, call it a day. Oh, something else I forgot to mention. The cars themselves actually run on gas, so if your car ever runs out of gas, you will just need to go to a gas station and fill up. I don't know what I'm doing. Like, I don't remember why I went to the map. So, that was weird. Anyway, whatever. We're near the end of the chapter. All we gotta do is eat a sandwich and go to bed. And then that's the end of chapter 5, the bus saw. And I'll see you in chapter 6, time well spent. Let's just get into my informal digs. And by that I mean my suit and fedora. Alright guys, I'll see you guys in the next episode. Bye.